Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Thanks for stopping by. Today I have a fun and exciting video. So I'm home right now for winter break from college, and I thought I'd do a highly recommended video on my hair journey. So I have all my old pictures here, and I'm gonna show you guys exactly what it looked like, how damaged it was, the process, and everything to get to the point where I'm at now. So I'm gonna have pictures listed kind of in this corner. I hope it's on this side, but you guys will be able to see while I'm talking exactly what it looked like and how I got to the point where I'm at today. So if you guys are interested to see how I get healthy hair, please continue watching, and I hope you guys enjoy. All right, so the first picture that's gonna pop up is when I was very young. You're gonna see how healthy and shiny my curls were. They were very tight and kind of ringlety. I had very kind of soft, soft texture. It was never too kinky or like too coarse for my mom to brush through. And then I'm going to show you here, in this picture you guys will be able to see that my mom kind of always pulled my hair back into a tight braid. It was definitely easy for her in middle school and elementary school, kind of just to put my hair back, braid it, and she'd always put coconut oil or some form of oil into my hair in order for it to get some type of moisture in it. I definitely was a tomboy in school, so having it pulled back was always a plus. I never had it this way, I never knew how to style it, what products to use, so it was always pulled back into a tight braid. So the next picture you guys will be able to see is a picture from when I was starting to go into middle school, high school. You guys can see that my hair had very tight, tight curls, kind of like what I have today, but longer, and they still were tight rather than falling down. I never really used heat in middle school or elementary school ever, unless my mom roller set my hair in order for my hair to get a break from being washed 24/7. But I definitely kind of kept it healthy, kept it on the right track until my mom introduced, or it was my, I think I saw a friend of mine straightening her hair, and so I was like, ooh, let me do that too. So instead of blow drying my hair, I would always kind of go and get it done, and they would roller set my hair first, blow dry it, and then straighten it. So this process kind of eliminates any extra heat damage that's going to be applied onto your hair. So I always love, till this day, I love setting my hair before straightening it. If I blow dry my hair, it's just adding way too much heat on top of straightening it. And when you have it set, it's already straight prior to straightening it. So it's easier for you to get it sleek, straight, and frizzless. So yeah. Next, I'm going to show you guys kind of in high school. I was a dancer, so every time I had performances, and even like for holidays or events, I tend to straighten my hair quite often. And I would leave my hair straight, I would say, for 2 weeks. Yeah, 2 weeks definitely, nothing longer than that, because I don't like it to be too oily. And then after that, I would wash it and just kind of use whatever products that I had in order to do a wash and go. I was not as informed as to like what products to use, what was good for you, what was bad for you. I kind of just went into CVS and bought mousse, gels, which is so bad for your hair if you're a curly hair girl, just because of all of the alcohol content in it. Yeah, so in this picture you guys will see that my hair is starting to break. I have damage, kind of frizzy hair as well. It was definitely very long, but I would straighten it way too often and kind of ruin the texture of my hair and the form of my curls, unfortunately. And I had nobody to kind of like look up to, or kind of no one to really bounce off ideas with how to do my hair. So I definitely started getting into YouTube kind of when I was a junior or sophomore in high school. Sunkissed Alba was definitely a girl who I really look up to and kind of learned a lot from her. Definitely how to deep condition, what shampoos, conditioners to use. That's when I started using Shea Moisture quite often. Till this day I still use it. I love their product. It's very good for my hair and it works really well with it. But yeah, so I started learning from her, but often still I would straighten my hair just because it was easier. I wouldn't have to worry about it for a few days, which I really loved about that. And I definitely felt the pressure in high school to always kind of have my hair straight. Yeah, so unfortunately I didn't really know anyone in high school who had hair like me, so that's why I kind of tended to straighten it quite often. I was actually really good at straightening my hair, and then I would always try to wand it or curl it once it started getting dirtier, just because you couldn't see the oil or the grease in my hair when I do curl it. As you guys can see, I'm gonna show you more pictures where it's just like me straightening my hair, the damage after when I would wash it. You could see the curl pattern was completely destroyed, uneven hair, breakage, and all that stuff. So once I got to college, I knew that my hair was damaged. It was definitely a point in time where I just needed to cut my hair. I would always still straighten my hair. I dance in college now as well, and so that was another excuse for me to straighten my hair, and I always had people around me straightening their hair who had curly hair, so I never really saw anyone kind of wearing their natural hair, unfortunately. But so I remember coming home Thanksgiving break, and I was like, I'm so over my hair. I would wear my hair actually natural more freshman year of college, and that's when I started to realize that my hair was completely damaged. So I came home Thanksgiving break and I was like, I'm over this. I hate the way my hair looks after I style it and it comes out so terrible. So I went to my hair salon. I had my hairstylist chop all my hair off. I remember I was like, I'm over it, cut it off. And he was like, are you sure? And I was like, yes, I'm so over this hair. And so he just gave me layers. As you guys can tell, he gave me layers. It was probably shoulder length, maybe even shorter than that, but as you guys can see, it was pretty short, the shortest I've ever had my hair. And then I remember leaving it straight for a week because I didn't want it to be any more heat damage than it had already been. So I left it for a week and then I washed it and it came out just like this. You can see my ends are still pretty damaged just because I would straighten my hair so often just to make it perfectly straight, where I would ruin all parts of my hair. I remember the front part of my hair was extremely damaged, and the crown of my head is where I would also put a lot of heat, unfortunately. But you can see in this picture, the hair shrunk after I washed it, obviously. But I did notice, I did notice a big difference in the softness in my hair. I definitely got that back after I did my big chop. So after I did my big chop, I would straighten my hair very, very, very rarely. It was kind of like only if I had a performance once again, and that was about it. So I would kind of condition it maybe once a week or once every 2 weeks, which is not as often as I should have done it, but I could feel a difference in my hair. I could feel it coming back. Although I hadn't completely stopped straightening my hair, it was better than what I had done in the past. It took a while to get my hair back to kind of like past the shoulder length. It took a while to get it to kind of even touching like boob length. Not that it took a while, but I would always do regular trims if I was home from school, which was definitely something that I tried to aim at doing better. So after I did my big chop, I kind of strayed away from straightening my hair, but I did do it rarely, but not as much as I did in high school. So as you guys can see in this picture, my hair is growing, the volume is coming back, my curls and the texture is coming back, as well as the shine. Oh, and another thing is I never really colored my hair. Well, I've never also had any perms or relaxers, any kind of chemical in my hair. My mom was always very strongly opinionated on me not getting any relaxers, any kind of chemicals in my hair. I never wanted it either. I knew I never needed it, but I always knew people in my family who got them. So just, yeah, never had any color or chemicals in my hair, which is why I always think that it was easy for me to kind of transition back to being natural, because I never had to deal with any kind of that kind of damage into my hair. But as you guys can tell, my hair is getting longer, it's getting bigger, more volume. As my hair is getting longer, I'm taking way better care of it. I'm watching way more people on YouTube who have hair like me, who I look up to as well. They definitely gave me kind of the path and the kind of confidence to wear my hair natural. I remember when I would straighten my hair, I'd repeatedly put heat on top of it again and again in order for it to get pinned straight. I wanted it to be perfect, and I'm definitely a perfectionist, but I definitely had heat closer towards the front of my hair and the crown of my head. And I think that's normal for a lot of girls because they want it to look perfect. And that was definitely the harder part for me to get back to get the curl back to its full texture. So the last part of my journey, I would say, was junior year of college, I kind of took the hair journey into full effect. I stopped straightening my hair. I deep conditioned probably 2 to 3 times a week. I really wanted my curls to look healthy. I knew it because I would wear my hair natural way more often, and I was like, Hermela, it looks good now, but in order for you to get it back to what it used to be, you gotta stop straightening it. So that's exactly what I did, and I got a lot of attention for how my hair looked so healthy, and I knew I was doing the right thing. As you guys can see, a lot of my pictures here are with my natural hair, and they're full, and my curls are back to life. Thankfully, it definitely took a while. And also at this point, I was in college, I saw so many girls with curly hair who were rocking it, and I wanted to be just like them. Yeah, so at this point, I've completely transitioned to wearing my hair natural. I would wash my hair about every 4 days, and then I would deep condition in between wash and goes. I would use products like products from Shea Moisture, Diva Curl, Kinky Curl, Bounce Curl. I love all of these products, and they work so well with my hair. I diffuse my hair now also. If I do straighten my hair, I straighten it probably every 4 months, 3 months, and I do it once. And once I straighten it that one time, I don't straighten it for the rest of that week until I want to curl it, and then I'll curl it once and then leave it for the rest of that week. So I try to minimize any kind of damage to my hair, and I also prepare my hair before and after when I apply any kind of heat to it, meaning I do deep conditions, I use coconut oil in order to prevent any kind of heat damage or damage to the texture of my hair. So yeah, so as you guys have seen, my hair journey started, I would say it started sometime freshman year of college, and I'm at the point where I'm a senior now in college, and my curls are at this point where they're bouncy, they're curly, they're healthy, shiny. Definitely not where I was a few years ago. Alright guys, so I hope you enjoyed the video. I really wanted to show you exactly how I got from the hair that I had in the past to how it is today. I really want to educate you guys on how long the process took. So I hope you guys learned a lot from it. And if so, please leave any comments or questions that you have down below. I hope you guys really enjoyed the video, and please don't forget to like it or subscribe to my channel. I'll see you guys next time. Thanks guys!